I'm joined now by Michael Mann, Presidential Distinguished Professor of Earth and Environmental Sciences at the University of Pennsylvania, Director of the Penn Center for Science, and author of Our Fragile Moment, How Lessons from Earth's Past Can Help Us Survive the Climate Crisis. Professor Mann, I'll start with this. I am not a meteorologist. I don't often watch the Weather Channel, but I know danger when I see it. I have been paying attention to the news. I have family and friends who are affected by this. What are we looking at in context right now? You know, the term storm of the century gets thrown out from time to time. Is that what we're looking at? Are we looking at something that we have not seen before and could have consequences to lives, to infrastructure, to the environment that we've never seen or haven't seen in a lifetime of most people watching?
Yeah, hi, Jason. It's good to be with you. And what we're witnessing is tragic, and it is the consequence of our ongoing burning of fossil fuels and the warming of the oceans. That extra heat in the oceans means that there's more energy available to intensify these storms. The peak wind speeds increased by about 12% for each degree Celsius, that's like nearly 2 degrees Fahrenheit. Each 2 degrees Fahrenheit of warming, you get a roughly 12% increase in those maximum wind speeds. And the destructive potential of a storm actually scales as the third power of the wind speed, which means that 12% increase in wind speed corresponds to like a 40% increase in the destructive potential, the power that is dissipated by this storm, the damage that's done. And so there's the intensity of this storm, there's the storm surge, which is a consequence of the intensity of the storm, the size of the storm, the fact that it was a Cat 5 storm out there for several days, built up a very large storm surge. So don't be fooled by the fact that it has weakened a bit over the last 24 hours or so. That storm surge that threatens the west coast of Florida was built up over several days. And we're gonna see that 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, maybe 14 foot storm surge in some locations along the west coast between Tampa, Sarasota. So this is a tragedy that's unfolding, and it's a tragedy that was, you know, created in part by our continued burning of fossil fuels and the warming of the planet that's caused.
You know, Professor Mann, I'm old enough to remember when, you know, we talked about global warming when I was a kid, and then it turned into climate change. And I think a lot of people didn't understand that climate change didn't mean that things were automatically going to get hotter. It also meant more extreme weather. Talk a little bit about what the consequences are of the increased frequency of these kinds of storms. Because the fact that we are 2 weeks away from Helene, the fact that there were over 100 tornadoes reported in one day in one particular state,
sure,
if this becomes the norm, what kind of world are we looking at in vast swaths of land in the United States?
Yeah, and I'll tell you, you know, what we're witnessing now, we're sort of stuck with. We're stuck with this new normal. That's a best case scenario. That's a scenario where we stop burning fossil fuels. We stop warming up the planet further. Then we're stuck with this level, the extreme weather events that we've seen summer after summer, these devastating, stronger, more flood producing hurricanes. We're sort of stuck with this, but we can still, you know, we're still within our adaptive capacity. We can adapt to the changes that we've witnessed thus far. It's going to take, you know, quite a bit of investment, and there's going to be suffering and harm that's done. We're already seeing that play out. This is a level of warming we can probably adapt to. But if we continue to warm up the planet even more, then pretty soon we're going to exceed our level of resilience. And so that's really the problem. These extreme weather events become more extreme. These hurricanes become stronger. The flooding becomes worse. Helene produced 50% more rainfall than it would have if we hadn't warmed up the planet. There was a study that came out just last week that demonstrated that. And we know hundreds of people died from that interior flooding, the flooding in various states of the southeastern U.S. That means people are dying because of the warming of the planet that has exacerbated these events. We're already seeing catastrophic consequences.
Michael Mann, thank you for that sobering but very important message about what we're facing as a planet. Much appreciated.
Thank you.